You've got to watch the video at the end of this one for more right knowledge for real.
Shalom, brothers and sisters. Shalom. Once again, it's the voice of Brother Tazer Doc coming at you as usual through the spirit of Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah. Begin all things with the illustrious name of Yahweh, the Creator. Today I wanted to talk to you about, or should I say on this Sabbath, I wanted to talk to you about DCT. Many of you may know what this is. Many of you may not. When I mention the acronym DTC, the first thing that should come to mind to those of you that know is the Jesuits. Now, DCT, I'm sorry, I keep saying DCT, it's the DTC. The DTC is a part of a two-part company. And the acronym DTC is for Depository Trust. The Depository Trust Company. Now you have what is known as the DTCC, which actually is an acronym for the Depository Trust Clearing Corporation. It is a corporation. The DTCC is controlled by the Jesuits. It's controlled by the Jesuits out of Rome, Italy. Now, this guy, Hans von Columban, also known as the Black Pope, owns the Federal Reserve. To those of you that do not know, if you don't believe me, do the extensive research and it should lead you back to him as the owner of the Federal Reserve, which is not federal, by the way. It's an offshore company. Why? Because it's out of Rome, Italy. And these people, they run the United Nations, they run the Vatican, they run the Roman Catholic Church, from which all forms of your Christianity comes from. So those of you that are screaming, Jesus, Jesus, my sweet Jesus, you're under their authority. So they run these things. They run the Vatican. They own a real power structure. Now, they run the Pentagon. Now, you can like it, understand it, believe it or not. So just do it. I'll tell you what, don't believe me. Do some research. Do some research on DTCC. Once again, that acronym is for the Depository Trust Clearing Corporation. It's a corporation. It's the parent company of other subdivisions thereof. And they run everything that I just named. Your court system is part of this. The court system is part of this, brothers and sisters. They own the Depository Trust Corporation, which is the DCT, and the Depository Trust Company. Now, these are two different separate entities, and they're subdivisions known as the National Security Clearing Corporation, NSCC. Then you have what is known as Mutual Security Clearing Corporation, MSCC. You see, these are all subdivisions, and they all fall under the DTCC, which are run by the Jesuits. And you also have Governmental Security Clearing Corporation, GSCC. Now, you should be writing this down, brothers and sisters, because this is some information that most people cannot get their hands, no less their minds on. So the DTC is a nominee. The word nominee means name. And when it speaks of that whore that's going down in the book of Revelations, We don't know who that's referring to. So she's a nominee known as, now in right here in New York City, Alpine Publisher has a Commodity and Security Exchange Act of 1933 and 1934. I want you guys to Google that and learn as much about that as you possibly can. Now, under Rule 12, under this Commodity and Security Exchange Act, which actually came out of the Alpine Publishing right here in New York City, under Rule 12, they register your birth certificate as a security in the name of what? Of code and company. Now, there are two types of securities, brothers and sisters. There's two different types of securities. There's a certified and there's an uncertified. Now, once your birth certificate is registered, it becomes a certified security. And it's registered in the name of code and company. Now, the registered holder is the registered owner. So they register, you send it to them to be registered. And the registered holder that's holding it, you're not holding it. If you lose your birth certificate, you have to send it off. You have to send off a request to get it. So the registered holder is the registered owner. Then you have what is known as the owner in fact. Who's that? That's you. But the registered owner controls everything, and you control nothing. What do you control? You damn so-called blacks and Hispanics, you don't control nothing. You don't even control your own lives. Y'all in the street, you're killing up each other. It's a Sabbath right now. I look out my window, there's all sorts of people out in the street partying or whatever, you so-called blacks and Hispanics. What do you control? They control it. They're the registered owner. You're the owner in fact. You don't control nothing. You can't even control your own children. They all have running wild, fulfilling the scriptures again. So the registered owner control everything. Now, the Supreme Court. Many of you get trials and you want to appeal and you say, we're going to take this to the Supreme Court. Now, what you think is the Supreme Court, and I'm sure they're going to come at me for this information, for letting this circulate, but they've been coming at me already. I mean, if your Yahweh's with you, many can be against you, but who could be against you and when? So I fear none. I walk as if I don't feel a thing. So the real Supreme Court is not the Supreme Court that you assumed it to be or what they make you think it is. Now, the real Supreme Court is in Washington, D.C., and which is the United States District Court. That's the real Supreme Court. There is no yellow fringes around the flag. There's none of that garbage. Because that yellow fringes on the flag makes it an admiralty flag. Whenever you walk into that, you're walking into an admiralty court. You're going into the laws of the sea. There is no yellow fringes on the flag in the real Supreme Court, which is, again, is the district court. It's the United States District Court in Washington, D.C. Now, Article 3, Section 1, that's what that's referring to. And what you think is the Supreme Court is an admiralty court, brothers and sisters. It's the highest admiralty court that they've been telling you that it's the Supreme Court. But what you're walking into is the highest admiralty court. So get ready to pay some money or do some time, baby. Or maybe a little bit of both. So that's their high court of justice. It's the Admiralty Court. It's not the Supreme Court. Now, 8-102 in the UCC, I want you to look it up. It explains what a security is. Now, each time, brothers and sisters, that you sign a promissory note for a bank loan, know what they do? Say you go to the bank and you get a loan. You sign the promissory note, which is a promise to say, pay. They're not giving you any money. Once again, this is not legal advice, so do not offer legal advice. If you need legal advice, seek yourself an attorney and please be advised. With that being said, let me continue. So when you go into a bank, you get a bank loan, you know, you sign your signature and so on and so forth. Your signature is actually covering that loan. That's what it's coming from. Now you could like it, understand it, believe it or not, but you need to start researching these things yourself. The first thing that they do is they endorse it on the back without recourse and pay to the order of, which is actually an order to pay. And guess who created this order to pay? You did, with your signature. But you're going to the bank and you're trying to get money that's actually not there. The bank has no money. It's your signature. So it starts out as a note, brothers and sisters. Then it becomes a security. And after it becomes a security, it becomes, they pull the note, they cluster the note, and when they cluster all the notes together, the security becomes what is known as bonds. And after they pull them, they're sold to financial markets. And if you doubt it, do the research. So a bond is merely an IOU. A bond is an IOU. You just give them the money. You just gave them the money with your signature, brothers and sisters. Everything you sign is a financial asset or a security. Everything. In some books that I recommend that you get, well, a book that I would recommend you to get is ABCs of the UCC by the American Bar Association. That's a recommended reading that I have for some of you. Now, when you walk into a courtroom, I don't want to go into that. We won't go into that. Let me tell you a little more about the DCT. And I'll bring this thing to a close. So the word understand, let me break that down real quick and I'm going to bring this thing to a close. The word under means you're liable. You're liable. So when you're going in, you're getting these loans, or when you're going into the court, or that judge is asking you, do you understand? The policeman is asking you, do you understand? The word under means liable or liability. The word stand means statute. And statute means bond or obligation of record. So understand is to be liable for the bond. This is why the people always end up in jail or prison. Because they say they understand, which makes them liable. Follow what I'm saying, brothers and sisters? To get out of prison, to those of you that may have loved ones in jail or prison, and they may not have committed the act as many of us usually don't, to get out of prison, you need two forms to get your loved ones or yourself out of prison. Optional form 90 and optional form 91, which actually can be downloaded from the internet. And in my conclusion, I also would like you to Google 48 CFR, Code of Federal Regulation. Google that and get smart on that as well. Once again, my name is Brother Taza Duck, and I would like to say Shalom, Shalom, Yasha'Allah.